Hi everyone, and welcome to the 23rd SAMR episode. SAMR is an acronym for Spooky Ask Me Everything, or Ask Me Anything, where an expert is invited onto our show to talk about the area of expertise. This week we have Dr. Antonio Ricardo Najas. He is a psychologist and acupuncturist with a doctorate in natural medicine and a PhD in integrative medicine from Quantum University. He works in his clinic with several therapeutic modalities. Amongst them is sound therapy, acupuncture, biomagnetism, and energy psychology. So welcome to our show, Dr. Ricardo. Can you please tell me a little about what led you to studies and research in the field of integrative medicines in vibrational therapies?
Hi, John. I am very happy to be here to share a little bit about my research, my studies. Thank you very much for the invitation. Congratulations on the work you have been doing. Let's go. It all started when I lost my beloved grandmother after developing throat cancer, dying 1 year after the diagnosis. Her suffering aroused in me the desire to seek new medicines and therapies where I could see how limited was the conventional medical approach. And years later, I lost my dog due to an osteosarcoma. So these situations motivated me even more in the search for new therapeutic modalities. So I found the works and researchers of Raymond Rive, Lakovsky, Antoine Priorat. I discovered quantum medicine, frequency approaches such as sound therapy, which I worked on my PhD thesis. And currently I am starting my journey with Spooky 2 and plasma generator. I believe that it will be a great partner in my clinical work.
Can you tell me a bit about your thesis, Dr. Ricardo?
Oh, of course. I really like to speak about my thesis. I'd like to show an image about this. We have here some pictures about the researchers, George Lakovsky, Antoine Priorat, Raymond Rive. These researchers who inspire me, research and studies. It's possible to see here a little bit about my dissertation, PhD dissertation. In my research, I did an investigation about the influence of sound therapy on the meridians of vital body. We know that each meridian has associated sound frequency. So I'd like to know if a sound produced by singing bowls is able to produce some energetic effect on the vital body. So my research was about the 12 singing bowls. If it's possible through the using of singing bowls, produce some positive effect on the vital body. The arrangement that I made was based on the 50 scale of Pythagoras. This is because this frequency scale is related to spiral flow of energy. The results showed that a sound field can improve the energetic state of meridians. To make this assessment, I used a device similar to Hildoraco. Did you hear about, do you know this device, Hildoraco?
No.
Did you hear about? No?
No.
It's a device. This device is capable of measuring the bioelectric activity of the meridians. I use a device similar called CCT, and I did a measurement before and after the sound bath, and I had a wonderful result. In a single session, I obtained at least 12% of improvement in the energy status of the patients undergoing the multi-frequency bath. So I proved that's possible to promote some positive effect on the vital body through using sound therapy, sound frequencies. We know that we have a sound body. Each meridian has a specific frequency, each chakra, each organ, each cell. So it's possible to promote some rebalancing on the physical body on the vital body, using sound therapy.
That's very, very intriguing. You mentioned the vital body. Can you please explain a bit more about that?
Yes. It's a complex question, but I will try to explain in English this subject. Within the framework of quantum medicine, meridians are channels through flow the qi, or vital energy. And they are located in the vital body. We have in vital body, it's possible to find the chakras and meridians of acupuncture. So the qi and the meridians are part of the vital body. The vital body is a kind of reservoir of morphogenetic fields or matrix structure that provides the models of the formation of physical body. At this point of view, John, the physical body may be a representation of a vital body. The physical body is the representation of a vital body.
Right. So we know the meridians are channels through which the qi between the arrays of the organs, the energy flows. But what is the importance of the qi balance?
It's a good question, because once balanced the flow of qi through the meridians, all organs are able to receive adequate energy nutrition. It's very important phenomenon, which is very important for the health of the organs. We know that the excess or deficiency of qi in the meridians can produce many symptoms or diseases in the physical body. So the good flows of the qi around the body, it's very important to our health, because the organs receive the appropriate energy to do
okay.
the better job, the better work.
I understand, but how does a person understand the relationship between emotions, feelings, thoughts, and the movements of morphogenetic fields and organs?
Yes, okay. The morphogenetic fields are classified into five categories according to the five elements of traditional Chinese medicine. We know there are five elements: fire, water, earth, metal, and wood. So each one is related to a specific morphogenetic field. In Chinese view, these fields are called Shen. In acupuncture, we know each organ has a specific emotional matrix called Shen, or morphogenetic field associated to. And they are associated with thought, feeling, and emotion. Another important point, John, there is a vital force that moves through the vital body, which is associated with thoughts and feelings that create various energetic signatures. The erroneous movement of the life force can cause diseases in the physical body. Therefore, Taoism, quantum medicine recognizes the existence of a close empirical relationship among organ, the morphogenetic field, and the five elements. Each organ is a physical representation of a morphogenetic field related to one of the five elements. An image about the vital body and morphogenetic fields. It's possible to see here the morphogenetic fields are informative fields. Actually, the modern physics named this field scalar field, scalar energy or scalar electromagnetism. And this kind of energy, scalar energies, is able to order the biological system and may be related to the vital body. Each organ is associated with an informative scalar field and an acupuncture meridian. This field informs and organizes the functioning of the energy and biological system. This information is very important. We have here the five elements: wood, fire, earth, metal, and water. The morphogenetic fields can be classified into five elements. It's possible to see here the wood element associated to liver and gallbladder, because each element has a specific relationship with a specific organ and viscera. We have here fire, the fire element associated to heart, pericardium, small intestine. We have the earth element associated to stomach, spleen. We have after the metal element associated to lungs and colon and kidney, and water, the element, water element associated to kidney, bladder, bones. So there is a profound relationship between scalar energy or informative field and organs, meridians, chakras, and so on.
So what does modern science have to say about the quantum or wave mode?
Yes, I will show a picture about this. About your question, the morphogenetic fields are classified into five categories according to the five elements, how I said before. In the Chinese view, John, these fields are called Shen. Another important part, there is a vital force that moves through the vital body. So it's important to recognize this field has a dual nature, based on analyses and experiments in quantum physics. It has been found that light has a dual behavior, either as a particle or as a wave. In Chinese medicine, the organ is associated to particle aspect, and the viscera is associated to wave aspect. It's a very complex subject, but the scientist Louis de Broglie hypothesized that if light is dual in nature, a particle would also have wave characteristics. De Broglie associated the dual nature of light with the behavior of the electron, and stated that every electron in motion is associated with a characteristic wave. So this information is very important in quantum medicine field, because each organ has a specific frequency or wave nature associated to. So each organ has a specific energetic or frequency signature. It's very important. We can recognize that any kind of disease or symptom may be associated to a changing of frequency. So it's possible when you corrected the frequency associated to an organ or cell, it's possible to promote I believe that's possible to promote some kind of healing when you correct the frequency. Because the matter has a wave characteristic. This wave has a vibration. Vibration is frequency. So all things in the universe have a frequency, have is vibration.
Okay. The chi and meridians have got both corpuscular and wave nature. In Chinese medicine, what is Wu Li?
It's a good question. It's a good question because in Chinese, the word Wu, we have here the Wu Li waves. Here we have Wu Li. What is it? In Chinese, the word Wu can mean both matter and energy. And Li can mean universal order, universal law, or organic models. The word Wu Li, therefore, means models of organic energy. The word Wu Li can also be translated into quantum physics as wave-particle duality. It's very interesting point because the ancient traditional Chinese medicine is meeting the modern science. These findings point to the fact that all matter has a wave and frequency associated. In other words, a subtler dimension that transcends the limits of classical view. The universe isn't mechanical device. The universe is an organic being. So this information is very important because represents a new paradigm in science. This wave field has an informative nature, which is able to guide and organize everything that happens on the physical level, emotional level, or spiritual level. Therefore, Wu Li is a complex network involving matter, energy, frequencies, and morphogenetic fields.
Right. More and more discoveries of quantum physics are increasingly validating the ancient knowledge of traditional Chinese medicine. Tell me, Dr. Ricardo, what is your opinion on that?
Yes, the basis of traditional Chinese medicine is related to an organic and holistic model of the universe, which regards energy and consciousness as the basis of the matter. It's a very important point because the matter is not done by matter. It's done by energy. It's done by information. It's an important point. The new physicists state that the matter is not only made of matter, but also a crystallized form of energy and information. Quantum physics says that the smallest particle, subatomic particle, are not material, but information fields. In modern science, this information fields is named scalar energy. I think in future, it will be possible to transfer bio information from the one organ to the other organ, for example, health organ to the disease organ, I think there are a lot of devices that are able to do this at this moment. In traditional Chinese medicine, these fields, scalar fields, are known as Shen. And in both views, they are movement, connection, and information. Yeah. I think this knowledge is very important because each organ has a Shen associated to. This Shen is what the modern science named scalar energy. In Chinese medicine, this energy is associated to Shen or emotional matrices. It's a very complex subject.
Tell me, Dr. Ricardo, are the meridians optical channels?
The idea that acupuncture meridians are channels or optical fiber is being increasingly accepted by research due to the support of quantum physics. The light traveling through these pseudo optical channels or meridians is known as biophotons. I have here some pictures about this. We have here an image associated to the biophotons. We have here a channel where the biophotons are able to flow. The high organization, according to modern biology or quantum biology, in the high organization of structural and dynamic process of human body requires a wide bioinformation transfer capacity between the brain and the organs. This communication system appears to be based on the transmission of electromagnetic signals or radiation. And it may be related to the network of meridians of Chinese medicine. So what we call meridians in Chinese medicine? In modern science, it's possible to associate these meridians to the fiber, optical fiber. It's very interesting association. So the vital body, I talked about vital body before. The vital body may be formed by a network of quantum nature optical fibers in which bioinformation radiation circulates. In Chinese medicine, the vital energy has an energetic and informative nature at the same time. The ancient knowledge and now then scientific validity. I think we are living in a special moment because the ancient traditions are meeting the modern science. A wonderful meeting involving modern science and ancient knowledge.
Right. Can traditional Chinese medicine be explained through quantum theory?
The photons coherent. The photons coherent theory in biological system proposed by Pope, for example, may be the key to the understanding of traditional Chinese medicine. It's possible that the electromagnetic radiation from the human body can be related to the qi or qi of the traditional Chinese medicine. Many studies suggest that the intensity and amount of the biophoton can be changed when the body suffers from an illness or disease. For example, the photo emission is lower in patients with hyperthyroidism. We have here an image about human biophotons. It's very interesting, this image, because it's possible to see here, John, the shape of biophotons. This shape is associated to secret geometry. It's a very interesting point here. It's wonderful knowledge. This is because of the metabolic activity, speaking about lower emission of biophotons in patients with hyperthyroidism. This is because the metabolic activity of these patients is reduced. Lower emission was also found in patients whose thyroid gland has been removed. The breaking of the symmetry of the biophotons emission from the right and left hands, for example, can happen in some diseases. I have here another image. It's possible to see here the biophotons emission from the hands. Cohen and Pope found that the percentage of the difference in the emission of photons between the right and left hands can be a parameter of analysis of health status. This finding may serve as a basis for a better understanding of what is the yin-yang imbalance in the vital body. So it's possible to analyze this through using through biophotons analysis. It's possible to do some diagnostic through this information. Many studies have shown that after acupuncture treatment, the difference between biophotons emissions by right and left hands can drop dramatically.
It's remarkable.
In ancient medicine, in traditional medicine, this knowledge is associated to yin and yang polarities. It's a very interesting association.
Yes. Is the photonic body of quantum biology what the Buddhists call the rainbow body?
Yes, I think so. According to, I have an image here about this. According to recent research in quantum biology, the body has a bioinformation network of optical channels or meridians through which light particles of various frequencies are circulating. They are able to generate syntropy in complex biological processes. These light particles are known as biophotons, and they can present different frequencies and colors, because we know each color is associated to a specific frequency. The rainbow body of the great perfection of Tibetan Buddhism seems to have some similarities to the quantum body formed by biophotons of quantum biology. It's possible to see here in the screen, an image about this Tibetan tradition associated to rainbow body.
Right. Do you currently apply?
There is another important point, John. Sorry. There is a profound relationship between sound and light. It's important because the photons, the biophotons, have a sound nature. So, in quantum biology, in quantum medicine, this is the sound nature of biophoton is associated to phonons. We have photons and phonons. So when we speak about biophotons and light particles, we are speaking too also about sound frequencies, sound vibrations.
Okay. Do you currently apply the sound field in your clinic work? And if so, what kind of complaints can be addressed using that technique?
Yes, any complaint can be worked out with this technique. The improvement of the quantum state of the meridian is capable to give an energetic support. Therefore, John, the organism works of more effective form in its process of cure. As complementary supportive therapy, it can be used in the treatment of physical, emotional, and mental symptoms.
There's quite a broad spectrum of ailments that you can treat. I've also heard that you've developed a therapeutic modality called scalar quantum healing. Can you please talk a bit about that?
Yes, of course. I really like to speak about this therapeutic modality because I dedicated many years to develop this therapeutic approach. According to we have in Chinese astrology, we have something named the four pillars of destiny. What is it? It's an important point in this approach because we all have an energy field that is determined by the year, month, day, and hour and time of birth. We all have an energy field that is determined by the year, month, day, and hour of birth. It's a very important information. Each of these pillars is associated with a quantum scalar matrix composed of an energetic influence coming from the universe and another coming from the Earth planet. This field, this process configures an energetic identity with 8 specific energy portals that can be associated, that can be activated by 8 associated frequencies. Many vibrational tools can be used for this. For example, sound, color, aroma, floral, sometimes magnetic field. Based on this, I have created a therapeutic work that uses the information present in this field. This field, John, has the shape of two inverted pyramids, one facing up and one facing down. The upward facing pyramid is related to cosmic influence, and the downward facing pyramid is related to earth influence. When I use the associated points and frequency, it's possible to activate the patient's healing potential. I have created many techniques for this, using sound, chromatic frequency or aromatic frequency or floral, bifloral. I can also put magnets or apply laser in the 8 points, energetic points of the octahedral field. Each face of the pyramids, eight in total, is related to a particular I Ching trigram, an acupuncture point and frequency key. So in this approach, it's possible to work to do some therapeutic intervention according to octahedral field associated to the patient, determined by year, month, day, and hour of birth. And important information, the physical body is enveloped by a hyperfield in the higher dimensional space. This hyperfield has the toroidal form, an interdimensional vortex, formed by multiple layers of energy and information. The energy is associated to quantum phenomena, and the information is associated to scalar or informative field. I have here another picture related to about quantum scalar matrices. You can see here the five elements, each one associated to a planet like Venus. Venus is associated to metal force, lungs, organs, large intestine organs. Mars, planet associated to fire force, heart, small intestine. The Saturn planet associated in the center, associated to spleen and pancreas or stomach. Mercury planet associated to water force, kidneys and bladder. And Jupiter planet associated to wood force and liver and gallbladder organ. So it's possible to see here an important association among cosmic influence, organs, elements, and meridians. The ancients knew that energetic and formative matrices have a decisive influence on the human being at the time of his birth, and specifically at the time on the first brief. The first brief is very important. It is the moment where we receive this influence, this cosmic influence.
Okay. You use sounds, colors, aromas, floral aromas for your treatments. Are these different forms of treatment interconnected?
I can use different frequency stimuli that are in agreement with the patient's octahedral field. I have developed several therapeutic protocols that use sounds, magnetic fields, aromas, colors, and bath flower. Sometimes it's possible to use all together or almost all together in the same session. But each case is a specific case. But each phase of the pyramid, each phase is associated to a specific frequency. I can use sound frequency, I can use aroma frequency, I can use floral frequency or color frequency, since this frequency is associated to the specific octahedral field of the patient.
Okay, we touched earlier on, we talked quite a bit about the Chinese medicine. You were talking about the faces of the pyramids. Can you go into more details, please, on that subject?
Yes, of course, John. This is a very complex subject, and it's related to the more esoteric part of Chinese medicine. Each face of the pyramid is related to a trigram or informative field, an acupuncture point, and a specific frequency signature, which can be translated into aroma, color, sound, and so on. I just said about this. According to Chinese astrology, when we are born, we are influenced by the heaven and earth's energies. The heaven's energies are 10, and the earth's energies are 12, totalized 112 combinations, but only eight it will determine the octahedral field. All these energies have correlations with acupuncture points, archetypes. Carl Gustav Jung studied very well this subject about the archetypes, five elements, and associated frequencies. When I speak about archetypes, I am speaking about informative fields. So all this together determines the octahedral field, and when you treat some diseases or symptoms according to this octahedral field, the results is incredible. When you use some therapeutic tools associated to this octahedral field, the results are incredible, because you are working in agreement of the nature or essence of the patient. And other information about the four pillars of destiny. According to the four pillars of destiny of Chinese astrology, we all have an energy field that is determined by the year, month, day, and time of birth. Here we have the octahedral field. Each of these pillars is associated with quantum scalar matrix composed of an energetic influence coming from the universe and another coming from the planet Earth. I talked about this before. Yes, we have here another image. It's possible to see here the octahedral field. We have in the center, in this X, we have the earth element. We have here metal element, water element, wood element, fire element in the center. The scalar quantum healing works with a geometric representation of the quantum identity determined by four pillars. In the center of the octahedral field, we have the four elements of traditional Chinese medicine. And a central X that crosses this field connected to the earth element. This configures an energetic identity with eight specific energy portals, eight faces of the pyramids. It's more clear now that we have possible to see, to realize this information through this image that can be activated by eight associated frequencies. In my course, I teach how to identify these energetic or frequency keys. Many vibrational tools can be used for this. And sounds, colors, aromas, floral, and so on. Based on this, I have created a therapeutic work that uses the information present in this field. And this field, how I said before, has the shape of two inverted pyramids. Also, here we have an image about this information. The Earth's influence are related to 12 archetypes, the astrology studies this kind of influence.
Does this have any physical base, Dr. Ricardo? Does this have any physical base?
Yes. Let me see here where is. Here. Here we have pictures about this. Physicists have recently discovered that the basis of matter is made up of quantum octahedral structures. The theory of the prions recognizes that the octahedral form is related to the particles that form the matter. So here we have a physical base to our approach. For this approach.
Okay. Talking about the meridians of acupuncture and how the five elements of Chinese medicine are related.
Oh, yes. The five elements, John, of Chinese medicines are related to the meridians of acupuncture. And also, each one of the 12 archetypes are also related to certain points of acupuncture. Thus, it's possible to identify in the octahedral field eight energetic points associated to the acupuncture. Each person has eight energetic points that are part of his octahedral field or energetic identity. Once triggered by specific frequencies, they are able to mobilize the healing potential of the organism. We have here an important picture. You can see here one pyramid facing up and the other facing down. The first one is related to galactic heart, and the pyramid facing down is related to the earth heart. It's very interesting, and in the end, it's possible to see here an axis in the center related to the chakras and some meridians of acupuncture.
Right.
Here we have the chakras and the octahedral field. The chakras are situated in the center, on the center of this octahedral field. There is a central axis that runs through the octahedral field. The chakras, the conception and governing vessels, meridians, are on this central axis.
How does the I Ching come into your approach?
We have here information about the I Ching and octahedral field. Have you heard about primordial cells?
Yes.
You hear about?
Yes.
Yes.
Early stage cells that can change function.
Yes. The 80 trigrams of the I Ching are related to this octahedral field, as well as the 8 primordial cells. One moment, please. These 8 cells are related to personal Akashic field. It's important to this information. But this is a very complex subject to be addressed now. Each person has in his field 80 trigrams that are determined in the year, month, day, and time of birth. And each trigram is associated with an information or scalar field and certain energy process. We have here the 8 trigrams, the egg of life, and the 8 primordial cells. I think in informative medicine, I think this information is very important, because in these primordial cells, through the primordial cells, it's possible to search the Akashic field. But this question is very complex. In the other opportunity, I can speak more about this subject.
Okay, I'd like to skip to a final question, if you don't mind. And it's one of my favorite things I'd like to learn more about. It's the use of sounds in medicine. You say that you've used 12 bowls, for example, for treating people. Can you expand a bit more on that, please?
Yes, John. The researcher Fabian Meinen proposed a different relationship between the musical notes and the 5 elements of acupuncture. This information is wonderful, because according to their studies, for example, the element wood element is associated with the note A. The fire element is associated with the note C. The earth element is associated with the F note. The metal element is associated with the note G, and the element water is associated with the note G. So it's possible to do some therapeutic job using sound, using sound vibration or singing bowls, for example. We can associate each note of the chromatic scale with an acupuncture meridian. C is associated with the meridian of the small intestine. C sharp is associated with the meridian of the bladder. D is associated with the kidney meridian. D sharp is associated with the meridian of the pericardium. A is associated with the triple heater. F is associated with the meridian of the gallbladder. F sharp is associated with the meridian of the liver. G is associated with the meridian of the lungs. G sharp is associated with the large intestine. The A note is associated with the meridian of the stomach. A sharp is associated with the meridian of the spleen, and C is associated with the meridian of the heart. So we have here an important information, and so it's possible to promote some rebalance, energetic rebalance on the vital body using sound vibration. Each note is associated a specific meridian or organ or emotion, because each organ is associated with an emotional matrix. So it's possible to connect several kinds of the information.
That's very, very good to know. Well, thank you so much for your time, Dr. Ricardo. We have come to the end of our seminar. Thank you for talking to us about these different modes of healing and treatment. I'd like to thank the people watching this video for participating. And goodbye. That's the seminar. Finished. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. And thank you, Dr. Ricardo. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Joe. I'd like to thank you, everyone, for the attention. Thank you.